Wily smugglers. In fact, I'm going to let you retake those. I'm going to go to Chester. Smuggling is an activity if the most simple-minded can decide to pursue. The only difference is they get caught. More worrying are those with genuine talent in knowing and who to bribe and what lies to tell to elude capture. And as smuggling becomes more profitable, there tends to grow in numbers. We've been on the trail of some particularly clever band of smugglers recently, and the network of deceit they have managed to create to continue their operations continues to surprise us. How should we go about resolving this? Send out the best men, which will cost me some money and some diplo. We can recruit them for more spy network generation, which honestly we just don't need. So we'll send the best men. In fact, what I want to do is I'm going to split you in half. Capture more stuff, more fast. The French are killing the Irish troops. Thank you. Chester is mine, and with it the war score. Coventry. It's going to take Leicester. Burn Windsor to the ground. Or London. It's tradition. There might be problems with the French in the future. Maybe. But by that point, I'll own England. And, in fact, much of the UK. Let's go to Hull. It is, after all, one of the great universities. Are you going for London again? Please say you are. No, you're going for Coventry. Interesting. Nope, you're leaving. I think we probably should do something about those guys. Stability increase for free. Our decision to give more power to the local magnates has ensured that people of importance feel good about the government. So they've been telling everyone else how they are being governed. Cool. Still losing me some money, but that's fine. Right, let's go and find these wayward English. What's the peace deal going to look like? It's going to be extremely in my favour. Because this war is being pursued by my allies for favours. I don't need to give them anything. Where are you hiding? There you are. Except that's only half of your army. Where are the rest? You're in Cornwall. Are you really hiding from me in Cornwall? Nope. Okay, I don't know where you are. Time for the blanket. And we're going to take the south coast so that if the French come back, then they'll start sieging stuff for me. What does it say, my income? I can hover over it, so I'm losing 2 ducats a month at the moment. That should balance out a bit as I'm looting these territories. In fact, I'm gonna just loot the south. Spoils of war, 2.8 a month at the moment. Ka-chink. Probably even more. And the good thing about this is it means that those provinces are going to be devastated as well. Oh, I see the red and green plus. Yes, exactly. So at the moment I'm positive, probably because I'm looting. When I'm not looting, it's negative. You're trying to siege down Cumbria, that's fine. As long as you're not going for Chester, I don't really care. Oh, the English want peace, do they? Peace in our time. Right, Cornwall's been fully looted. I'm seeing the loot here. So Somerset is very nearly done. Dorset only just started, really. And the more you loot, the more devastation they suffer, which means the less that province will earn for quite a while, actually. So they are looting me up here, but it's fine. Their provinces are on 12% devastation. That's huge. Alright, Somerset's done. Let's go to Gloucester. In fact, what I should really be doing is just trying to finish this war. I'd like you guys to go and take over Sligo, please. Or, I mean, Ireland. Well, there's nobody around us. We'll take a bit of a risk. If we see these guys heading south again, though, we'll start to coalesce. At least the more territories we're taking, the less troops that they can rebuild. Alright, you should be done. Go over to Kent. Yeah, close enough. Like how I've left Gwynedd alone. I just haven't got to it yet. It will fall. Don't worry. Yeah, I think for this fight, I'm going to leave Ireland for now. I mostly want Lancashire. I also want this, so I can complete those areas. There we go. This will piss off England, Kildare, Burgundy, Desmond and Tyrconnell. I have no idea whether that's probably Irish. That would be a good deal, actually. We can get this right now. It doesn't overextend me either. Cuts off Wales, which is nice. Leaves them with the south, which is fine. And this should complete my next mission, too. Into England. We need to take Yorkshire, East Midlands and West Midlands, which we will have done. And then we will get permanent claims on East Anglia and London, so here and here. In that case, I don't want to be looting that, because I'm going to be taking it. In fact, screw it. Let's just end it. This is already a 99% peace deal. Send. Thank you! England will cede Gloucester, Shrewsbury, Lincolnshire, Derby, Hull, Coventry, Chester, Leicester to Scotland. England will pay 750 ducats to Scotland, the Allies, of which I get 230. Now, of course, the others get some, don't they? Denmark gains 10 power projection, France gets 10 power projection, Scotland gets 10 power projection. Because we all dislike the English. And there we go, victory is ours. Huzzah. Huzzah, huzzah, huzzah. Let's stop paying people. Let's bring the forts down. And let's pay some loans back, I would say. In fact, yeah, let's pay off as many as we can. Now we're making a decent amount of money. Right, next thing that we need to do is wait for the war exhaustion to go down, then buy these. In fact, I'm just going to go ahead and start coring the cheap ones, because it won't matter. And we've fulfilled a mission. We have suffered at the hands of the English armies for too long. Scotland must cement its position in northern Britain by annexing Northumbria into its domain. You have completed it. Next up, Greater London. And then we'll get a permanent claim on Wessex and Wales. So here and here. Having already claimed those two. Marvellous! A good side Scotland, but soon a greater Scotland. Yeah, exactly. Now I would definitely say the English have been humbled. And they will have been spending a lot of money on all the mercenaries that they were buying. I'm kind of curious to see how many loans they're in now. They're bankrupt again. Sorry, but totally and utterly not sorry. That's the second time they've gone bankrupt this game. And of course, the estates want a piece of the pie. You know what? Poll looks reasonable. We'll give that to the clergy. There you go. Stop moaning. And with that, we can think about going up in... No. No. No, 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 no. Bad. Ah, because I took these territories from London, from England, that actually puts me over the minimum required to embrace the Renaissance. And for that, it's actually worth taking loans out, so I kind of wasted a bit, but never mind. Then, whoops. Oh, you were kidding me, just short. Alright, 2 more months, then we'll embrace. Also, the forts can go down. Press the wrong button. I meant to do that one. England started to inflate Ormond. They're not going to be a great power for much longer. Ah, all a glorious taking. Talking about Britain, any faction in specific that interests me in... T.O.B. I don't know what T.O.B. is. Wales have an uprising and free themselves from the yoke of English scum. GB's mission tree is the largest one, I believe. Yeah, probably. They've done a pretty good job with Scotland. Austria's declared war on Venice. Imperial ban. Also, I seem to have some more troops down here. Right, now I can embrace the Renaissance. Boom. And technology. Diplo. Not yet. Not over the limits, fine. My innovativeness is 2.4 and still going up. Good. Oh, Thrones of Britannia. Gotcha. I haven't been watching the faction details very closely, I must admit. Because 99.9% certain that I'll play as the Danish first. And then after that, probably Alfred. Seeing as he's one of my favourite historical figures. I think he's fascinating. So I can... hang on. Cessation of church functions. Noble families are often granted control over church lands and appointments were made in many states in exchange for cash contributions to the Crown's efforts. The Crown, of course, lost control over some revenues this way in exchange for a short-term boost. So we lose 15% national tax for 20 years. No, I'd rather have the stability, thanks. Revolt. Oh, down there. Eh, you can deal with it. That's been cored. How's the war exhaustion looking? It's going down. I mean, actually, what I could do is have you guys come over here and we'll just raise your morale kind of at the last minute. Ah, except I can't actually get to you, can I? Can't go over... Can't get across England. Never mind. Sorry, Sligo, you're on your own. Ah. Besides, you guys can start protecting trade in the English Channel. Speaking of which further, I really just need to take London, then I can switch my trade capital down to London. Because I don't think you can change it within a province. I mean, it really doesn't matter where it is, just a point of pride that it's like in the best trade spot. So at the moment, I'm still collecting in both North Sea and England Channel, English Channel. Denmark is now considered a great power. Ulster has risen up. Now that's a fight I can help with. And Denmark. Relations are very high. Burgundy is conquering Castile. Interesting. I'm going to continue improving relations with Aragon. I want to see if I can help you. And also Portugal. Portugal remains a good option. Let's cancel claiming you. Portugal would actually accept an alliance right now. Aragon has rivaled you. Well, all things considered, Portugal would actually be a better ally because Aragon's slowly but surely being annihilated. As much as I would love to see an Aragon supreme Spain. Oh, but Aragon specifically hates England. Ooh, the other thing I should do is improve relations with Burgundy so that they are not outraged at me. France is improving Provence. Still at 3%. Which translates to how much? 11% increased cost. That's what, 4 points? 5, 6, 7. Yeah, we can definitely save some political power. Monarch points if we don't do that. If you form GB, you get the GB missions. True, but I'm so tempted to just stay as Scotland. I'm so tempted to do that. We'd laugh if Cornwall and Wales broke away. They might well do, while they're bankrupt. Like any uprisings that England has, they're just not going to be able to fight off. Is Castile under a personal union under Portugal? They are as well. Interesting. So while Castile is a Portuguese personal union, Aragon is much less likely to... Well, I don't think they can be married to Castile. Which means you're not going to get the union between them. I really want to befriend Aragon now. I think that'll be interesting. My lord, Byzantium has fallen to the Saracens, the last bastion of the Roman Empire. The city of Constantine is now in Turkish hands. As Christendom reels from the shock, Byzantine refugees flock to the cities and courts of Europe, bringing with them old manuscripts of classical knowledge, tracts by Aristotle, Plato, and Galen, and a thorough knowledge of both Latin and Greek. Inviting these refugees to Scotland might provide an enormous boost to our own efforts. Yeah, absolutely. Mine's 10 tech cost. Let them come. Absolutely. Right, I am now strong enough. Let's go and fight them. Although this is a crossing, unfortunately. Let's do a quick shift consolidate there. Hi. Still smashing you, even with a -3. Because my general is amazing. Simples. Alright, let's get back up to speed 4, I'd say. And it's back under my control. Yeah. Annoyed that there's not much I can do about the peasants in Sligo right now. Impressive, Byzantium lasted until 1484. Yeah, that's true, actually. Oh no, Brandenburg, no! Losing to the Palatinate of all people. -50. So they're on the verge of not being able to join coalitions. Savoy has hired a French army. Who's Savoy fighting? Austria and Hungary. Ah, okay. Fair enough. Denmark has started to influence Norway. I think that's the second time they've done that. Renewed loan. Good grief, Sligo. What are you doing? He just gave up to them, yeah. Reasonable choice, to be honest. Reasonable. Oh, I'm still paying my army. I shouldn't be. And we have one idle diplomat who I'm going to send to the Papal States for a while. Alright, how is the raw exhaustion looking? It's going down. Once it's at like 1%, then I would say it's reasonable to go ahead and spend. England have, strangely enough, rivaled me. Comet sighted. Oh, Comet Devil's kith and kin. Oh. Austria at war with Venice looks like it'll get strong. Yeah, Austria's having a pretty good game. Burgundy is no longer rivals with England, despite the fact that they've still not taken Calais off of them. How large is England's navy? I mean, their army is going to be pitiful. 12,000. England, navy, they still have 2 heavies and 5 lights. I mean, that wouldn't be impossible for me to overcome once all my loans are paid off. Aragon is now 100. Come on. Ally with me. You're mostly concerned about my naval strength, which, considering I control most of Albion, is a problem. England's having a peasants' war. I had nothing to do with this. This is not Scotland's fault. England is not having a good game here. Not even slightly good. Alright, let's do all of those. Then we can afford an idea, which is going to be tax modifier. I do still have high corruption. You know what? That's fine. And then I'm going to start paying some money to root out that corruption. We'll do 2 ducats a month. Ish. The last jousting competition tournament. We can feel it in the wind. Soon our equestrian elite will be nothing more than a dream remembered. As chivalrous tradition dies before the onslaught of modernity. The world is changing, but for now, for one last time, let the Knights of Scotland ride. Cost me 22 ducats. That is reasonable. And their rebels just crossed the borders into my lands. Oh, I think they were just crossing over. We still have enough. Pay off the loan. How much interest am I paying? 1.55. I still have 6 loans outstanding. Denmark's declared war on Poland. Coalition? Poland, what have you done? You've severely pissed Denmark off. Nobody else... Oh no. Brandenburg really doesn't like you. Pomerania really doesn't like you. And oh my gosh. Livonian or Ho, you've taken over the Livonians. I see. Meanwhile, Novgorod has again died. That's a nation that could do with a buff, is Novgorod. Played as Novgorod several times, and it's just a exercise in frustration. New technology, we could get another Diplo. Can I subsidize the English peasants? I could, but I don't really see any point in it. I mean, England is bankrupt. 5,000 peasants are beating 13,000 Englishmen right now. Yeah, let's go up in Diplo. This will actually put me ahead of time in trade as well, so that's another 20% income. Oh man, there are so many peasants. They don't need any help. They don't need any help. Improve relations with Burgundy. So Burgundy is now below the aggressive expansion required to join a coalition against me. Good. So my allies are still completely chill. Holland is still a junior partner. Friesland is growing enormously. You know what? I think it's time to send out some envoys to Friesland. Being a Dutch state, they're going to have a large navy as well. Although, less important now, seeing as I can probably outproduce the English now at this point. I once again have a lot of military points, so I think we're going to go ahead and invest in some more military development. In fact, let's just do this wherever's cheapest. We're going to be getting more from them in the future anyway. Investing in York. Why am I investing in York? That'll do. England, spying on me. How long is the truce? 98. Still another 12 years before that finishes. So never mind. It's kind of funny watching you play as Novgorod as well. The Timurids. Ooh, rebels. Uh-oh, we're going to be taking out another loan. At least I'm getting some manpower at this point. Separatism. Ugh. Growth of the administration. As the state and its bureaucracy grew, there was an ever-growing need of people to oversee and administrate the various lands and functions. The nobility have traditionally been more associated with military services to the state, but have increasingly made it clear they still expect to be first in line when government offices are being handed out. The burghers, on the other hand, claim that the nobility consider such appointments as mere rewards and will only use them to enrich themselves. Instead, the burghers argue we should appoint men out of individual merit. The unexpected death of a trusted secretary has left a vacant position to be filled as the centre of this conflict, with the burghers supporting one candidate and the nobility wanting to pick another. So we can get additional diplomatic relations if we go with the nobles. We gain more trade power, or we could give it to the clergy. So the nobility at the moment are dangerous. We do not want to give them any more influence. I think this one's going to go to the burghers. Plus, this means the burghers will give me some more money. To the burghers it goes. Then the burghers, in exchange, can give me money. There we go, that stops me taking a loan. Just in the nick of time. Also, I still want the admin support. So now if we support the clergy, we can get that. It's 100 admin. That's going to be nice. I don't think I particularly want to do anything with the nobles, though. Right, let's go off to the 4,000. We'll use that to give you some more morale from the victory. Glorious as it will be. Alright, diplomat's done. Is there anyone else in particular I should be reaching out to? Ah, screw it. We're going to try and get this alliance with Portugal. And then we completely will crush the English. Portuguese, Castellan, French, and Danish navies all combined. Yeah, good luck with that. Let them take Chester, that's annoying. All because I wasn't watching for a second. Another crushing and glorious victory. Why would they want to separate and join England? Look what's happening to them. And there we go. Some more cores. We could also do the areas, which we probably should. How many states can I have before we do this? 12. I have 7. Oh yeah, we've got plenty. Go ahead. And Ulster should be cored. Right, having won the fight, so I don't need to be recruiting anymore. Let's go and drop you. Chester's fallen, Shrewsbury's fallen. Lovely. Let's go and stand in Lancashire. Group. There should be stable government. Several of the leading members of government are deeply worried about how some changes proposed to the realm should be ruled. They demand a stop to such outrageous reforms, based on tried and proved traditions, naturally avoiding mentioning how the changes impact their own power base. Threaten to expose their secrets unless they back down, because we are an intricate web weaver. That's actually true, I haven't looked at my ruler at all. Oh, the Queen Consort is another shock person. Although, actually, King James is rather good. Oh, the other thing I can do is stop focusing on military. Do I want to focus on admin? Yes, because we are behind the times in admin, and we also have economic ideas I want to get through. Yeah, Granada beat Castile and is currently in the process of beating the unified Portuguese Castellan military too. France has paid all of Genoa's debt off. That's very good of you, France. Wait,